I can confidently say that many of you here today are facing an enemy. When I say this statement, people automatically jump to a conclusion that an enemy is a human opposition. But an enemy is not always a person. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Ephesians 6:12 says, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places." The enemy is not necessarily a person. For some of you, it may present itself in the form of an illness. It may have haunted your family for years. You say your grandmother had it, your mother had it, and now you've accepted the fact that you're going to have it. And you sit there saying it runs in the family, when in reality, it's the enemy. It is the enemy attacking you and your family in every single generation, using the same strategy, the same game plan, and I am afraid to say, some of you just let it happen. It is time for it to stop. Today, you must stop the enemy. For others, the enemy may present itself in your financial life. You know that your financial goals are attainable, and you have been trying for years, but for one reason or another, you haven't been able to achieve it. You may have a great job that pays well, but for some reason, you always find yourself behind on bills and struggling to keep up. Some of you may save a lot of money. Maybe you want to buy a new house or new car. But then something always comes up that sets you back, and you find yourself at the square one again. And for others, the enemy may be a series of unfortunate circumstances that always happen to you. And the world has lied to you and told you that you are just an unlucky individual. As children of God, we do not believe in luck, because luck runs out. As a child of God, you are blessed and highly favored, and the blessings of the Lord never run out. But some have gone your whole life experiencing an enemy of progress. In everything you do, it goes wrong. You take one step forward, and the enemy of progress pulls you two steps back. I may not have stated the enemy that you are currently facing, but you know what battle you are in the middle of, and you may feel like you are losing the battle right now, and it looks like everything is closing in on you, and hell is about to throw the finishing blow. But the God we serve do not leave us defenseless. He left us armed with prayer. For some of you, the situation is so dark and dismal that even when you try to pray, no words come out. Are you currently in that situation? Or have you ever been in that situation? Church of Jesus Christ, I encourage you to pray on. You need to pray as if your life depends on it, because it does. A Christian that does not pray is a weak Christian. A Christian that does not pray is a vulnerable Christian. Living a prayerless life is living an exposed life. Any wind and wave can come along and blow you to and fro. Jesus said, "Men are always to pray and not faint." Are you about to faint? Jesus said, "Don't faint. Don't give up. Don't run." God said in Jeremiah 33:3, "Call unto me and I will answer you." Not Gabriel, not Michael, but God himself said, "I will answer you." When you are at the edge of giving up, when you have run out of your own resources, mental resources, physical resources, emotional resources. When you have gone as far as you can go, that's just the beginning of God. He can do exceedingly above all that we can ask or think. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers them out of them all. The only thing that can change your situation is prayer. Jesus said in Matthew 6:7, when you pray, not if you pray, but when. Prayer is not an option for the believer. Prayer is not a last resort when all else has failed. As a child of God, you are instructed to have a continual conversation with God. A three-worded Bible verse that will walk you through your Christian life in Thessalonians 5:17. Pray without ceasing. That means talk to your God constantly. You need to have an aggressive prayer life. Prayer goes further than you can go. Prayer transcends time, space, and matter. Prayer opens up the gates of heaven and shuts the gates of hell. In whatever situation you find yourself, pray, pray, pray. In whatever season in your life, pray. God wants to do a great and mighty things in your life. The Bible says, you have not because you ask not. The initiative lies with you. Do not be afraid in your situation. Yes, there is an enemy you are facing. Yes, there's an adversary who is the devil. But fear not, because your Father in heaven is God, and there is no one higher than Him. With God, all things are possible. He can do above and beyond all that you can ask or think. Your God can do anything.